Firstly, thank y'all so much for coming here, for being here. Right, like everyone knows about what it looks like for a girl to have that issue. But what does it look like for us to have mommy issues? And it's not about pointing the finger, but it's about saying, this is my journey, this is my truth, this is how this affected me, how can I become the best version of myself? Healing is available and attainable and accessible. I want us just to have the tools to become whole, y'all. Our families deserve healing. Our families deserve a new narrative. A new narrative.
Every one of us is worthy. Worthy of love.
And expectations, and they had an expectation of you. You had an expectation of them. You know, you had you were loving and living their potential and not necessarily the person. So I fall in love with who you were supposed to be, or the destiny that God had promised me that you would be, without really loving like who you are right here in this moment, because you haven't become who God told me you were going to be yet. So I got to love the son before I love the preacher. I got to raise the daughter before I raise the worshiper. But so many times in the church, we fall in love with destiny before we fall in love with our sons and daughters.
What I think is important is that you start identifying what those triggers are.
Yeah.
And so for me, like, in order to identify that I struggle with perfectionism or that I struggle with self-acceptance, I have these moments of why am I not feeling amazing right now? Why am I feeling like I have to have it this way right now? Like, and so it's those small check-ins with myself that then make me sit back and start unpacking and saying, okay, so let me go all the way back to seeing why. And then when you ask yourself why and you start trying to uncover what it is that it actually generated from, then you can then say, okay, then this is where this comes from and this is where, and you'll be able to easily identify. But until I was able to even say, hey, I have a mother wound, had to accept it, right? Because I love her fiercely. Now, today, love her fiercely, long to hear her voice. Yet at the same time, and, right? Yeah. Both and are true, that I understand, like, you know, just the root of some of the things that I've gone through.
Yeah.